Howdy folks, Jeff and Lorena here at Back to Country. It's a beautiful morning. We're fixing to get over to the bee yard and do us a little bee wrangling. So come on and join us. So we have a swarm that's moved into the trap, and now we're just waiting for the foragers to come home. Hey folks, we're here at the swarm trap. We've got a new swarm that's been in there for a couple days. And what we're doing tonight is we're trapping them in the trap. So we've got a piece of screen and basically some duct tape. This is Gorilla Tape, which is the strongest duct tape known to man, I think. I don't know. But anyway, it works good. And so I'm gonna climb up there and I'm gonna put this over the entrance and hopefully trap those bees inside for the night. It's about 8:20, I think. Sunset was at like 8:06, so it's not quite dark, but haven't seen any bees come in for a little bit, so go ahead and do this. Ooh, there's a lot of them right at the entrance. Not happy.
So it was a bee flying around Jeff. Then she came to me and got tangled in my hair. And I was jumping and running away. Okay, here we go. So tonight we're just gonna place the trap next to the hive. And tomorrow morning or afternoon, Jeff, what are we gonna do? Morning, afternoon.
Morning. We'll come and...
we'll come and open it.
Okay, so...
transfer them.
Lots of bees still in there. Not happy because they're trapped in there.
Okay. Let me see. Yeah. You.
Okay, so we're over here at the bee yard. We're fixing to open up this swarm trap, see what we got inside. And we're gonna move these bees into this hive. Now what we've done so far is we put a feeder at the front entrance. I don't have any sugar, but I do have honey, so what I did was I took some honey and I mixed it 50-50 with water. And the reason I did that is if you think of how a swarm works, the first thing that swarm does is they gorge themselves with honey before they vacate the original hive. And that honey they carry to their next location, and they use that honey to begin building the new hive. That's their food and resource for their initial travel time, or however you want to look at it. So what I didn't want to do was give them pure honey, which then basically outfits them to immediately abscond and swarm again. I was hoping that by mixing it with water, what that would do is make them have to work a little bit, meaning fan the honey to dehydrate it again and get it down to acceptable level, which means it's not immediately ready to travel. Okay, so we got all the screws out. We are ready to open this up and see what we've got inside. Here we go. And so we've got a nice cluster of bees. Now, a very interesting thing that we see inside is a lot of paper shavings. So something has been chewing on this hive. I think the bees have. Not really sure why, but we got a nice cluster of bees in there. This isn't a giant swarm, but it'll definitely do. So we're gonna work on getting this moved into the hive. And so we're gonna try a little trick here. We're gonna take this comb. Got some old dark comb here. We're gonna put it under this cluster. And I'm trying to see if they will start moving onto it. Now the temperature is a little bit lower than normal this morning, so that could be keeping them in a cluster. Now I can see there's some comb inside of this cluster. They have made some comb in there. So they're not wanting to move yet. I'm gonna stir them up now, see if we can get them to there's already some on it, but okay, so we can see a couple of combs hanging there. Looks like they built two or three little combs in there. So I'm hoping that by turning it now, that's going to get them moving a little bit. Big old fat drone. We know they were in there a couple days, and this is the comb that they built in a couple days. Oops. They've got a little bit of pollen bee bread in that one. See if I see a queen running around here anywhere. Thank you. I'm not seeing a queen. So she's probably still in that box. Thing with this such a small amount of comb here. So, since they had a little bit of bee bread already saved up in there, I'm just gonna stick that in there and hopefully they'll work with it. Trying not to take away any of their resources that they've already gained. They'll lose a little bit of that comb, but we've given them a jar of feed to help them make more.
Thank you.
The nice thing is these are real gentle bees. I mean, there's no attack. They're not hitting me. They're not trying to sting me. They're just kind of saying, hey, what's going on here? We got bees in San Antonio, and man, those bees, as soon as you start even thinking about opening the hive, they're attacking the heck out of you. They're just very aggressive bees. Continue the search for the queen. If we find her and get her moved, then the hive will move with her. Onto the hive anyway, so now we're gonna leave them alone for a minute and see what they do. Thank you. So if you can see these bees here, see how they're fanning? All these bees with their tails up in the air and they're fanning. That's basically their way of saying, we're here, come here. It's calling all the other bees to the swarm. So when you see that kind of behavior, you know, typically that suggests that the queen is in there because they're calling everybody to the queen. You can see here's a bee on the edge of the box, just fanning away, sticking that tail up in the air and fanning. That's spreading those pheromones out, telling the rest of the bees, come here, come here. She's in there. And that's how you make a entrance reducer in the field. Okay, so just to recap what we've done, we took the swarm trap last night, we covered it with screens, so basically locking the bees in there, although there's still some little air vents that they were coming in and out, but just one or two at a time. The main swarm stayed in there in a cluster. It was a little cool this morning, so they stayed clustered. We were able to open the swarm trap up, transfer the bees. They did have three small pieces of comb made, maybe four, I can't remember. They put a little bit of bee bread in there, but that was it. So since there were no eggs or anything in there yet, that suggests that the queen is a virgin queen. We didn't see her, but she seemed to be in the cluster the way they were fanning and calling the bees in there. So I'm pretty confident the queen is in there with them. But like I say, we did not see her. I suspect it's a virgin queen because there were no eggs or anything yet, which means she needs to get mated and everything else. Now, the hive did have several drones with it. They won't mate with their own drones, but that's a good sign. If they've got drones, there's other hives around with drones. So hopefully she'll get mated well and this hive will take off. We didn't have sugar, so I took honey and I mixed it with 50% water to give it runny solution, but also so that it would not be ready to fill their honey stomachs and abscond again with it. I wanted them to have some resources to start building comb, but not resources that they could immediately abscond. So hopefully that'll keep them in there. We've reduced the entrance down, and you know, right now the bees are just kind of flying around because we got them stirred up and they're, you know, trying to figure out what's going on. But hopefully they will take to this new hive and everything will be good. So we'll keep an eye on them, but we're not going to open it up or bother them for at least a week. So that's pretty much where we're at.
And we will name this hive the Mother's Day Hive.
Yes.
Because today is Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day to all you mothers out there. Today is Mother's Day, and this is now the Mother's Day Hive. So, as always, don't forget to like and subscribe. Hit that bell so you get notified of when we put out other videos. Thanks for watching. God bless, and have a great day.